Hi everyone, in this video we'll discuss a very popular and common technique in NVivo, metric coding. Metric coding queries can be used as an effective comparative analysis. This tool is used to ask a wide range of questions about patterns in the data and gain access to the content that shows those patterns. For example, you could use a metric coding query to compare what different demographic groups have said about an experience, an attitude, or an issue, compare terms used in different contexts, or compare attitudes. In our project, we can use metric coding queries to compare differences among research groups in terms of the attitude toward being a researcher, benefits, challenges, and support. The attributes for researchers include age, gender, discipline, or stage. Before using the metric coding queries, it's important to develop and create case classification. We've done that in another video. Here's a case classification for our project. So how is it different from cross-tab query that we cover in other videos? Cross-tab query also allows us to cross-compare between nodes and attributes. The primary difference is that cross-tab query only allows us to select the entire attributes. We cannot select just a single part of an attribute, limiting our choices. For example, we can select gender in cross-tab query, but cannot select just male option. Similarly, you can select discipline, but cannot select one specific discipline for comparison. Metric coding query is much more versatile and allows us to select any part of nodes or attributes for comparison. In this video, we will compare the differences in attitude among researcher groups. On the Explore tab in the menu bar, choose Metric Coding Query. The Metric Coding Query dialog box opens. On the Rows tab, we need to define the rows of the metric. We click the plus sign and choose Select Items, which opens up all items in the projects. We select codes and choose the nodes of interest. In this case, we select positive and negative attitudes for the comparison. Note that I do not select attitude since it will show the aggregated results. Click Select. The criteria are added to the rows box. It is important to review the path of the nodes to make sure we have the right one. In the columns box, we need to define the columns of the matrix. Click the plus sign and choose select attribute values. It will show us all attributes. We select case classification on the left and then select person. This is a case classification we created before. We choose gender as the attribute to be used for the comparison. We select both male and female by holding the shift key. Note that I do not select unassigned and not applicable. Since they are not part of our classification sheet, click select attribute values. The criteria are added to the columns box. Click run query. This is the result of the metric coding query. This table shows the attitude by gender. As we can see, one male researcher has a negative attitude toward being a researcher. 8 male researchers have a positive attitude. As for female researchers, 2 female researchers show a negative attitude, while 8 of them show a positive attitude. Note that the total may not be the same since some researchers might show both negative and positive attitudes. So it depends on how you code the data. Again, you can always go back and modify your codes. If you use the window version, you can click on chart tab, which will show the metric coding results in a graph. This feature shows us different chart options such as 2D, 3D, in different color schemes. We can also change the chart type to select the best one. However, the Mac version does not have the built-in chart feature. We can only change the color scheme of the table. We move the mouse over the metrics, right-click, and select cell shading. Then we select the color scheme we want, for example, red, yellow, green. Now we have a good-looking metric. To create charts for this metric, the easiest way is to copy the results to Excel and create charts. You can save the results for review later. This is useful when you want to keep a record of the queries we run. Select Save Results up there. I will name it Attitude versus Gender. So if you want to revisit these results, we just go to Queries on the left, select Query Results, and choose our query. Double click on it and we'll see the same query results again. We'll try another metric coding for a different comparison. In this case, we'll select a different node, time requirements and work pressures under challenges. Click select on the column box. We select a different attribute for researchers, stage in their career. So we select case classification, select person, stage, and check beginner, earlier career, non-academic, established, and experience, and run query. This is the results of that metric coding query. For most researchers, work pressure is a major challenge compared to time requirements. Only one researcher at each stage selects time requirements as a challenge. The work pressure is not even among researchers. Non-academic researchers who work for industry or companies perceive work pressure as a major challenge, while established researchers do not think work pressure is the issue. Beginners and researchers in early career also perceive work pressure as a factor. This is an interesting finding that we can discuss further in the discussion section. Again, we store these results in a folder called Challenge versus Stage, and we can revisit these results at any time later. That is how to perform metric coding queries using NVivo. Thank you, and bye now. Thank you.